Boards and booze and boards, drink some beers, fight some hordes, drank too much, forgot our swords, ran back home, filled our gourds, got drunk again, sang some chords, boards and booze and boards, with Mickey and Jeb.
I was thinking of saying bonus episode. All right.
What's the bonus, Jeb?
The bonus is Android Mainframe, which, wow, this is really surprising because it came out, what, 2 days ago? Three days ago?
We're right on top of it this time.
Yep, so we're going to shoot this video out pretty quick and see if people like it. We've yet to play it, so it'll be our first time playing it also.
Yeah, so you'll get to see us make all the mistakes, and you guys can comment and say you guys are dumb and you should have done this.
Yep, should have played a game that we know.
Right, so, yeah. Set in the Android universe, well, we have both read the rules, and I think what we do know about it is when you were a kid, if you ever played the game Dots, where you draw a bunch of dots on a piece of paper, and then you alternate with whoever you're playing against to try to make a square. That's what this game is based on in principle, with making it more sophisticated.
Yeah.
But essentially, that's what you're trying to do. You're trying to make, what do they call them? In this, do you know?
The boxes?
Quadrants or something like that. I don't remember what they call them yet. But we'll look it up and tell you in just a minute when we go through setup. But essentially, that's what you're trying to do. You're trying to lock your particular character into a certain part on the grid. Just like in the old game of Dots, you were trying to create those squares for yourself.
Yep. It's a 2-4 player game. Fantasy Flight Games. Android Universe, like you said. I think this is what they're... fourth Android universe game,
because Netrunner, and then
the big
Android, the board game.
Yeah, so I don't know if there's anything else besides that, but
yeah, because I don't think they did the original Netrunner card game with somebody else. Actually, Wizard of the Coast, they just dumped it.
You're right,
because Magic was so big. Anyways,
yeah, so 2-4 players, Fantasy Flight, and we will get to playing it, so you can see...
Set up first. And
set up, how to play, and then we'll do a game, and you can see how it turns out when we play it.
Yeah.
So, all right.
All right, back in a minute.
All right, so to begin, we're going to show you the components of the game. The first thing is the plastic board, and as you can see, there are four interlocking pieces, and right now there's three of them, and Mickey will show you how to put the fourth one in. And all of them kind of go in the same way.
But it does have to go in a particular order, it won't work.
Yep, so that's how you build the plastic board, pretty easy. On the board itself, there are nodes and paths, and the nodes are just the squares, and the paths are where you would put these things. So that's like a path, and then the node would just be like, bam. So that's the plastic board. Next are the generic program cards.
The generic back, blue back, that's what the cards look like. They have basically have patterns of how you're going to be able to put stuff on the board.
So there's five different things that can show up in it, and I'll put up pictures as I say this, but the first is move an access point. So that one just moves an access point to any empty space. That one, access point. Point or the squares. Yep.
Sorry, wrong one.
That one's a swap. So the second one is access point swap, where you would swap two face-up access points. The third is a partition movement. So you move a partition. That's a partition movement. Yep. Next is a free partition placement. So you get to place two partitions from the supply onto any empty paths. That one. And then the last one is limited partition placement, and that's the shape. Like, they'll give a shape on it, and you have to place it exactly as the shape is, but you can rotate it. You can't mirror it.
Right.
Aside from those, there are unique program cards, and Mickey is moving them. That's for whichever player you are. There's six runners, and each of them has their own deck of cards.
And in typical Netrunner fashion, these cards are beautiful.
Oh yeah.
And the artwork is spectacular.
And I believe they're all people who are already out in the Netrunner game itself.
I believe so. They look familiar.
The only one, I'm not sure if it's the blue one. I can't remember who that one is up top.
That's the one of the, that's the, is that Santiago the criminal?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I'd have to
look. Does it say in here?
It probably does. Anyway, digressing. These are the access
Nero.
Nero. Access point tokens, there are one for each player, and there's a front and a back. The face up side has the person's face, the face down side has their symbol. And then partition pieces are the blue pieces, and as you saw, they're placed on empty paths, and they're used to close off zones that we'll talk about in a minute.
And that's pretty much it for components, guys.
Yep,
so,
that's the components. It's a quick game, or small, quick game, whatever. Alright, so setup. First thing is assemble the board. So, Mickey's already done that. Next is create a partition supply, which is just a pile of the pieces. Wow. Already we've done it.
Yes.
Determine first player. So that one you just randomly decide who's first. After that, you choose runners starting with the first player. And
so
going
if I was first, let's see, I'll take Chaos.
Yeah, each of the decks actually have different cards in them, so they're
right.
Like
so
specific to each player.
You have five specific to the runner that you take, so you'll take those five cards and the tokens that go with it.
Yep, and I'll take Kate just for convenience sake. So after Mickey chose, I chose.
And we can put these aside, but remember you can play up to four people.
All right. The next thing we do is create the program stack. So to do that, you take the generic programs and shuffle them and just place that next to the board. After that, we've got prepare runners.
Can you still see that over there?
Yeah.
Because those are going to get flipped.
Yep. So for preparing runners, everybody shuffles their runner decks and they draw three cards. And then the other two, I believe, are just set out of the game. So I've got my three, and the other two are out. And then we each have our eight access points. After we prepare the runners, place initial access point tokens. So the first player, in clockwise order, will place one access point face up on an empty space. So Mickey is first player. I'll start down here. And finally, after that, we create the program suite. So to do that, you draw the top four cards of the program stack and just set them next to the board. And that is everything for setup for the game.
That's how you set it up.
Yep. So pretty simple, right? All right, so for gameplay, the way Mainframe is played is over a series of turns. On your turn, there are three things you can do, and if you cannot do any of the three, your turn is skipped.
I believe you have to do it, and if you can too, right?
Right. That's a big thing to remember. You can't just skip for no reason. The first thing is to execute a generic program, and what that means is take a card from the suite, play it, and then that means do whatever the card says, discard it, and then replace it.
Right. So in this case, this one called lock has a U shape. I would make a U shape on the board. Like that.
Yep.
And then discard the card and fill it in with a new one.
Yep, and that's the action for his turn. Another thing you could do is execute a unique program.
That's
and
cards from your hand.
Yep, you only have three of them, and once you play one, then you do not replace it. So you only have three for the entire game.
I'll mention it right now, since Jeb and I were just discussing it behind the scenes. We were looking through the unique cards. There is no legend for the unique cards in the rules. Not usually typical of a fantasy flight game. So when we play, if we come across stuff we're not sure, we're going to make our best guess on what it does. Hopefully we're pretty accurate from playing their games before.
Yeah.
But a little bit disappointing, actually.
And then, so that's the second thing you could do. The third thing is place an access point. And to do that, Mickey will show you what you have to do.
You will place it, and then you discard the top card of this deck. So that's never going to get to come into play.
Yep. So those are the three things you can do on your turn. And if you can't do any of them, then your turn is skipped. And no optional skipping. So a couple of terms that you need to know for the game. A zone is a group of nodes enclosed by partitions. So the nodes are just the smaller squares, and the partitions are the blue things that are going on the paths. So Mickey just created a zone. However, you cannot place a partition in a zone and create a zone that does not have an access point in it. So if that was there and Mickey closed it off, then good for him.
Now it's a legal zone.
Yep. And it's also a secured zone, which is a zone that has access points for only one runner. And when it is created, the face-up access points get flipped face-down.
Making it secured.
Yep. Secured zones, the access points in a secured zone are unaffected by programs, and partitions and access points cannot be placed inside. So right now, Mickey has, if you'll flip his over to secure it. On my turn, I could not place this here because it's already a secured zone. The next example is an unsecured zone. So if that is defined as a zone with access points with multiple runners inside.
So before I shut it off, if Jeb's token was there and then I went like that, it's a unsecured zone.
Yep.
Correct.
And for unsecured zones, everything inside is able to be affected by things like programs. And also, you can place the partitions in there. So if on Mickey's turn, he's like, I'm going to place that there, then he just created two secured zones. So both of our access points would flip over and they'd become secure.
But I actually end up scoring more with it.
Yep. And that's pretty much it for the rules. The game ends under three conditions. There's no programs that can be legally played. The program stack runs out. So if that deck runs out, the game's over. And if all players skip their turn in a row, which is supposedly the rare case, then the game's over. And for in-game scoring, a face-down access point is worth points equal to the number of spaces in its zone. So if the game, for some reason, ended right now...
Jeff would have one.
Yep.
I would have 1-2.
Yep.
However, if I had 2 in there when I secured it, I would have 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yep. Each one is worth a point for each zone in it.
Yep. So,
yep. And any face-up access points at the end of the game are worth nothing. So if there was an unsecured zone and there were 2 people in it, then no points for that. And then finally, the winner is the person who has the most points, and there are tiebreakers like most secured zones and then largest secured zone. So that's about it for the game. It's pretty simple. So I guess, is there anything you need to mention? Or?
I don't think so.
All right, so we will get to gameplay really quick. All right, we're here for gameplay of Android Mainframe. We randomly decided Mickey's going to go first, so he chose Chaos Theory,
which is the green card.
And then I go next, and I am going to choose Noise, so I've got the red ones. And Kim's with us, and she chose Kate, which is the yellow ones, I believe.
Yep. So she has her cards. So
she gets
hers. Yep. And now everybody's going to place one of, starting with me, going to place one of their tokens on the board wherever they want. I will go there.
I will go here.
Now we will reveal the top 4 of the programs.
Alright, so lock makes a U-shape. Block makes a half H shape. Fetch lets you move one. And replicate lets you place 2 from the supply.
When it says place 2, is that anywhere, or is it in that shape?
Nope.
Oh, okay. That one just happens to be, that's okay. That one's just a any. So, I am going to just because we don't know what we're doing yet. I'm going to replicate. Randomly start some crap.
Alright, so since he played that, he discarded it after using its effect, and that replaces it.
And shift means you get to move an access point, right, Jeb?
Shift, yep. Yeah. You move an access point to an empty space.
And it's anybody's, right? So you can screw somebody over, right?
Yep. I am going to play lock, which makes a U-shape. Like that, and then flip that.
Can move his guy just for
him. All right, Ken's go.
So I could do this one?
If you wanted to, yep.
So to do it...
To build a T-shape.
That's what I was looking for, not a half H-shape.
So I could do it...
Is that what you were calling it?
Yeah.
Like that?
You only get...
No, that one's already there, okay. So that's
yep,
right.
Yep, you did it. And then this gets replaced. Ah.
I will fetch.
Oh, you suck.
Okay, this is going to be a fun game.
Oh, not with three swaps out there.
Oh my gosh!
I am going to activate a shift and move my guy... Oh, you're good, Kim.
How could I utilize that? I'm gonna do this one, but
eat another tea.
Yeah, I guess I'll do it this way.
Wow.
Now, how do we place these?
On your turn, it's an action where you discard the top card of the deck to place it.
Oh, okay.
Which I think Mickey... got rid of a swap. I don't know if they can see these. It doesn't really matter. I guess I'm going to do... What is that? Veer? Yeah, Veer. I don't know if I want to do that.
You have it going the right way?
Yep.
You sure do.
And replace it with...
Oh my gosh, are you serious?
That might be due to bad shuffling.
I did it pretty well.
I shuffled a little bit too.
Uh-oh, Kim's doing shenanigans.
Uh-oh. Good card.
What's Kim doing? So, oh no.
Well, if we discard stuff, do you replace them?
Yeah.
Okay, then I'll use this battering ram.
Whoa.
So I discard up to two programs from here, I guess.
Yeah.
So, yeah, whatever. And then I execute one. So you
one
said
of
you
the
would.
Ones that you just,
no,
oh, just,
so you would replace it first, right? So yeah. I can actually get something maybe useful.
Yep, you're right.
Is that how it reads?
Yep.
Okay.
Looks like she's
so
got
you
something.
Were saying I could rotate it to do.
Yep.
This.
Oh my gosh. Oh, and that gets replaced.
I use one of my special abilities to drop two.
Wow. Oh, why did I put that there?
So now if that closes, we both get the points.
Nope.
Mickey would get
nope.
Even
it has to be a single runner in there.
Yeah.
Well, how do you get rid of people then?
Swaps?
You can swap. You can build stuff within it while people are in there. But it's once only one runner is in a zone, then you get flipped over.
This game's messed up.
I am going to place an access point... You're good, Kim.
So, could this close that? I guess not, if it went the other way.
It wouldn't close it, but it would put a lot of stuff on the board.
If you do shenanigans over there, that's interesting.
I think I'll do it.
Okay.
So it'd be... Oh, wait, no, it wouldn't go like
that. You can't make it that way.
No. But I can make it this way.
Flip one. What? This is... Move something to an empty space?
Yeah, move an access point to an empty space.
Shouldn't it be the other way around? Have an access point
to an empty space? I think it's showing that it's out of that space now.
I would have done it the other way, I think. Where's Jeb?
You suck. You suck.
This game's gonna cause enemies.
Oh.
It doesn't matter. When I pick on you, you always come back with some phenomenal move and kill me.
I'm gonna do this. Here you go, Kevin.
Wow, those are some great options over there.
Yep.
Alright, so if I want to place a person, I just get rid of this?
Yep. Oh! Excellent!
Uh-oh, did I do something?
Skew.
Oh, you got that one.
Ooh, thank you. So, skew lets me place that shape.
And oh, Jeb got something!
I'm the only one in there.
Ah!
So I guess I should use this, because then I could do this, I guess?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it'll take long to even get anywhere. Just so
well, don't forget that once this is done, the game's over.
Mm. So we're already like halfway over.
Yeah.
Wow.
Uh-oh. You're moving one? Oh, it's my go, right?
Mm.
Oops. Oh! I'm being mean. Veer? Let's be close. Am I just missing that completely?
Could this do anything useful? No.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you... Oh, no, sorry. I was looking at it a different way.
See what happens when I mess with Joe. She just play my own game and leave him alone.
I think anybody who watches all our episodes is going to realize that. That is the life lesson of gaming.
But it's fun.
Oh, you moved me out. Oh.
I don't like any of that. Well. What?
Snowball?
Uh-oh.
Swap two access point tokens?
Uh-huh.
Put that over there, Joe. And then swap two access point tokens.
Oh, wow.
Secured, my friends.
What?
It's secured off.
Oh, because that doesn't matter that that thing's there.
Not that we know of.
Right.
Yeah, because it's only one runner in there now. Holy crap.
My cards don't do anything.
Really?
Mine just let me play these cards.
Really?
Yeah, it's just like pick one on top of the discard. They're not used
on
to
top of the discard? That can be really good.
Yeah, but it's just the same things, though, that are coming out. Like, it's not like there's rare ones that we've come across. There's usually multiple ones out.
I'm going to bring out an access point.
Let me see if they have an example. Yeah, they have an example of one, Jeb, with a random...
Okay. Yeah, I
figured it was, but...
That was a good play. Yep, I went. I just brought out another access point. Wow.
And you can't play it if there's already a piece there?
Yep. Wow. 18 points, Mickey. Wow.
When I was reading the cards and I saw the swap and then swap again, I was like, that's dangerous card right there.
Yeah, definitely.
I got a similar one. Join the party with him over here.
Nah, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Nah, you don't.
Yes, I want to.
I'm gonna play my card that affects you now. Yeah.
You can do it now?
Yeah. The beginning of another player's turn.
Yeah.
What do I do?
I pick what card you get to play.
Wow.
Oh.
From the discard?
No.
Oh.
From the program suit.
Oh, okay.
So, I'm going
What happens if you can't play it?
I think she would have to pick something I had to play.
You would think.
Yeah.
But can she make you play something, then it goes, haha, you can't do it anyway, you just miss your whole turn?
No, I doubt that.
So you're
I would like that if we could make Jeb miss his whole turn.
Oh, I know you would like that.
I might... Maybe. You're gonna play this one.
I'm playing the T.
But he gets to decide how he uses it, huh?
I've just been putting him over here. Yeah, I can decide.
That would be a good card if she saw something that like was out there that she knew you could do something and then forces you to use a different one.
It also could help me pick what card out of the discard, since I go after him, since I would know what card would be on top.
And it's, oh, that was my turn, so now it's your turn.
Mm-hmm. But what do I want to do is the question. Oh. It says, so I have to say, it says any discard pile, so that's a discard pile?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh.
Yeah.
That changes things.
What?
What's in here?
All of Mickey's good stuff.
Oh my gosh! What?
Oh, holy shit, the double swapper one?
Yes!
Yeah.
What?
Thank goodness that's locked down over there.
Oh my gosh.
So it lets you do it twice?
Yes! You don't, it's not, I wouldn't do it now, but knowing that you have that in your back pocket is huge.
Okay. So what am I actually gonna do?
She just instilled fear into all of us.
Fetch means I move it from somewhere else, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Alright, so I'll play fetch. What would be an annoying one?
Oh, she's gonna break that up. Oh.
Ouch.
Wow.
Oh, that hurts just a little bit. If you can drop two, that's a huge spot.
Thanks.
Dang. So much.
I'm gonna play Jin.
Oh crap.
Remove one access point token belonging to an opponent and replace it with one of your own.
Oh, that was cool.
Stop putting stuff in my zones!
Uh-huh.
Or my potential zones.
We only have enough to go around.
Yeah, I know. That's.
Play my last one.
What is that?
Place an access point belonging to an opponent.
Oh, come on.
And then place one access point of my own.
Oh, come on. Are you serious?
For real. Read the card.
I don't
know. We could replay that rumbling for you if you'd like, folks.
I guess I'll play it now.
Oh, what is it?
Remove one access point token belonging to each runner.
Oh.
That includes you, right?
Does it?
Well, you're a runner.
Does it say each other runner?
To each runner.
Yeah, you get rid of one of yours.
Crap.
Too.
Nice catch, kid.
That sucks. I didn't want to do that.
I wonder if there'll be an errata on that.
That sucks.
In the Netrunner game, that would apply to yourself, yeah. So.
Here I was thinking in my head the whole time it was everybody else.
And then Kim speaks up.
Thanks, Kim.
Flip it. That's a long row.
Oh,
What? Oh, you have something on another player's turn. Is this for me? Or is it the end
of it? It was play? After Kim played that card.
Okay.
Do I want to do it or not? No, I won't. See if that costs me the game.
So now it's almost over.
Yeah. Almost. Oh, you have... What is your last card? I don't like it. Somebody's gonna get rid of that! What are you gonna do? I hate you. Are you gonna knock me out of the league? Oh, Jeff, I'm gonna cry.
Well, none of those cards can even do anything for me. So...
Uh-oh. She's using her thing?
I guess, because...
Oh, yeah, you
can... There's no point to the game much anymore, so...
Which one are you going
to
use?
I guess I'll use the swappy one just to screw things around.
Oh, Jeff, you're going to get screwed, my friend!
Why are you screwing me over when Mickey's
so the these are one? The only pieces, right, that are actually still in play? Yeah.
So if he locks this down, he'll have 6 points.
This coming from the guy who has, what, 18, 19?
If he can lock this down and get rid of me, he'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 points. Which he's smiling big time.
So that was one.
Now that's going to hurt because he's got to get rid of two people. He has to have a god card to do that.
When it says swap two...
Wait, is that just the what top I did? Program? That was Mickey's top... No, Mickey's top program is that.
Oh.
It says the top program of any discard pile. So the Mickey played them in order where...
So this...
So is that what we do? We have...
Yeah.
Well, she can still drop two programs.
So these are...
Wait, where's Jeb's?
Right there.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna do this
Removing then. One from everyone?
Yeah, because I didn't get any points. So it doesn't matter.
So everybody removes one?
Yeah.
Oh, so that's Mickey's last one, right?
Oh.
Doesn't matter, I'm not going to score it. Most likely. Might be nice, but... But she can mess it up with that, too. That's discard pile. She could just move one barrier anywhere.
I'll trash these.
Wow. I am going to play mine on the end of her turn, which is execute this program immediately after...
somebody does something?
Executes a program. Okay. Duplicate that program, execute it, and then skip my next turn. So I get to copy Kim's program of executing the top program of any discard pile.
Twice?
No.
Is that what you said? Oh.
No, I just duplicate it, so I get to use it, and then I skip my next turn.
Oh, so you're going to be able to score that at least three if you want.
At least one access point token belonging to an opponent, and then place one belonging.
So you can try to undo what I did?
Yeah.
Slightly with that.
You can score 3 points.
But is it enough to win? Because I've got 4, 5, 6, 7...
8, 9, 10
against your... You already have 18 there. That's nuts.
I have 20 total.
I'm gonna use the one that lets me place an opponent's and then place mine, so I'm gonna place Kim's. No, I'll place Mickey's over here. And then I'll place mine there.
But you have to skip your next turn.
Yeah.
But that's gonna run out on my turn, right? Right now?
Yeah, I wouldn't have won anyway.
Oh. Well, did you have, like, before I messed that up, could you have done something there? Did you have an idea?
No, I wasn't able to.
Oh, you were freaking me out.
Yeah, I know.
I thought you were going to get that whole row, and I was like, no.
I kept playing it, because I thought, if I freak you out, you'll mess something up, but you didn't. And Kim decided to screw me over.
Yeah, I built a wall on that.
Why?
All right. Why? I'll play... This, and then this flips over.
Alright, that's the end of the game.
Oh, I didn't get any points.
Yeah, because somebody kept messing with me.
Wait, let's count Mickey's again.
0.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Time. Oh, yay, 18. 19, 20.
And I've got 1,
not enough,
Jeff. 2, 3, and 4 is 7. So it's
20-7-0. Alright.
I didn't want
That's the game. Wow.
What she said.
She said, I didn't like it.
I didn't get any points.
Well, that's because until she beat you handily, she didn't like the game.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh my
gosh.
Alright, so that was our gameplay of Android Mainframe.
Yeah, first.
First time we played it.
Fresh out of the box. I read the rules once, I think. Jeb read them once or twice. And we just went for it. So, overall, what'd you think?
I enjoyed it. It was a nice, quick game. What about you?
I felt the same way. I enjoyed it. I thought it was kind of a cool take on the old dots type of system with a whole bunch of twists and turns that made it so you can't be that person that got stuck with that, having to put that last line in.
Yeah.
All the squares turn to J's instead of M's.
Yeah. Because
that's a bad thing.
No, not for me. but yeah, when Mickey mentioned it was kind of an updated version of that, I was like, I can't even believe I forgot that I played that as a kid. Because I did. And when he mentioned it, I was like, yeah, I remember that game.
So. It's kind of the same thing.
I mean, yeah,
you just don't get the,
on that, but
you don't get to exactly pick where you put your lines because you have to take, you know, something that's in the program row or do an access point or whatever, so... but
yeah.
I'm gonna guess that whoever designed the game, that's what they were thinking of when they started with the base. Two thumbs up from us and
people we think might like it. If you're a fan of the Android universe, it has a nice it's got the flavor or the fluff of Android, so you've got that.
Yeah, probably not as much as the LCG, but you can see it and. Like I mentioned earlier, the artwork is phenomenal. Really, really cool looking.
Yeah. If you're looking for a short...
shorter game.
Yeah.
Box says a half an hour, and I don't doubt that it's a half an hour or shorter, particularly even once you get to know the game a little bit.
Yep.
Strategy people, I think, would like it.
Yep. People who might not like it, if you don't like short games, obviously, this is one of the quicker ones, so if you want something to fill up a whole day of gaming...
Yeah. If you hate Android...
Yeah.
I would say that also, if you're a person that would get frustrated by a game that can, like, totally flip in a second...
Yeah.
I think this could potentially, just because of the way some of the cards are and some of the things that could happen... You could be set to make the biggest move of your life because you plan to a T. Somebody drops a card and ruins everything. So.
Yeah, like how Mickey was in... I was winning, and then Mickey did his super phenomenal one card to come back and win, right?
I don't know what you're talking about.
let's see. So we liked it. Those are people who might like it, dislike it. What did you not like about the game?
What did I not like about the game? For me, I don't think there was a whole bunch I didn't like other than some of the stuff that Fantasy Flight did.
Right, yeah.
The game itself, for what I was expecting and what it was, I don't have any complaints.
Okay. For me, I think the rule book could have been done a little better. There were cards that, when we saw them, there was no explanation for the unique cards. They covered the generic cards well enough. But the unique cards, some of them didn't have text, they were just pictures. And you just, if you don't know what it means, then you just kind of have to do your best.
We're pretty sure that we got what they mean, and I'm assuming that they thought after you read what the other cards do that you would be able to figure it out, but... knowing what the gamer world's like, and even with a picture card, I could have interpreted that a couple different ways.
Yeah, I think they could have just done a little like FAQ blurb at the end that would have been like, the name of each of the programs just be like, this is what it does.
Right.
I mean, that,
for all the unique cards would have been a couple extra pages, and you would have had a legend to make sure you knew exactly what they do. At least the picture ones. The other ones are all text, so they're pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah.
We had a couple questions, if you watched the video, about, came up, actually Kim caught one where it said, the card said, each runner, and Jeb was like, oh, that's myself too.
Yeah.
We're pretty sure that's right, because most of the cards in a regular card game, if they don't say the word other,
then
it's you too.
Other than that, I think just the, I guess, personal beef was the little blue things. They didn't come in a Ziploc bag, so...
Yeah,
but that's only because Fantasy Flight usually is really good about that, and there's always bags for everything. Yeah. But, I mean, it's not huge.
They don't give you separate bags for everything, but usually stuff's in a bag.
Right. Yeah.
And usually a crappy insert. The insert's not too bad in here.
I wanted to show you that really quick, but... The insert, at first I thought it was crappy, but then, as you can see, you can actually fit the boards perfectly in there. It actually is filled pretty tight, and it keeps it all organized for you.
But usually there's so much loose space in these things. Although, if you sleeve all the cards, maybe they won't fit as good, I don't know. But not the worst job they've ever done on anything like that, so that's pretty cool.
I think that's about it, right?
Yeah, I think that's about it. So
We both liked it. Give it a shot if you can. At least try it out. I mean,
I don't have it yet, and I would probably pick it up for a game to be able to bring places and things like that. I thought it was good, and you finally got to see an episode where we didn't already know if we liked the game.
Yep.
And this one we got lucky, and we both enjoyed it. Know if I'd put it in my top three, but it's an awesome little game, I thought.
Yeah, nice game to take around and play places. So, thank you for watching. Check out our other videos. We've got regular episodes, bonus episodes. Yeah. Check out, we're trying to cover as much as we can, different types of games. So.
Yep. And we got Twitter, and we got Facebook, and we got YouTube.
Yep, so leave us comments, questions, feedback. Yeah. If you don't like me, I guess you can say it.
Yeah, keep that one to yourself.
So we'd love to hear your thoughts. And also fan pick episodes, we're doing those pretty at regular, so get us some.
And if you've already found something that we did wrong in this, pipe up, because like we mentioned, some of the stuff wasn't as clear as it probably could have been. So, anyways.
All right.
We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Boards and booze. Booze and boards. With Mickey and Jeb.